Did you ask him too?
Oh, why not?
Huh?
Okay, look. And she
What are you?
Cheese.
Whoa, it is hot out here, huh?
I told you. Camera's for microphone. As a Secret Service.
Rondo.
Secret Service is here today. He's watching after everybody. That's what he looks like. Oh, it's okay.
One more. Where's mom's
camera?
I'll go up for you.
We failed.
Hey,
mom. Mom, let me get one.
Nice wedding, huh?
Yes.
I feel so privileged to be the maid of honor.
You're next.
Oh gosh, not for a while. Give me about 10 years.
That's what you're supposed to do. Right there.
Ooh.
That's called bootlegging.
I'm literally calling
it. Like, made it get back.
Hey, Chris.
His underwear, he walked outside down to the laundry.
I wonder, he
turned on the dryer and he's sitting on top of the dryer. Just sitting here.
It's the ceiling, too. It gives that illusion, I think.
Yeah, like a wonder spot.
And they finally found him. The door was open. They found him sitting in the laundry. 3 o'clock in the morning.
I shouldn't drink. I want a cigarette.
Keep up the good work.
Month and 4 days.
Nice glasses.
Well,
don't waste my battery. You're wasting my battery. Turn it off. Yes, it is. The light is.
Grandparents, this is run by a stand, Mr. Oswald. Next up, Susan's parents, Sheila and Tyrez. Welcome to John's parents, Kevin and Brian Rosen. Next up, we meet Carol and Mike Loving. I think that's the correct name. I love that. Followed closely by Chris Maloney and Ron Dokamidon Healy. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, your song stand at the altar. Here they are again. Let's bring them out. The best man and maid of honor, Jennifer Neely and Dan Cole. A lot of people come out there, I think, ladies and gentlemen. You know them, you love them, you came here to drink their wine and eat their food. Put your hands together. Champagne on your tables, is that correct?
Good deal.
That's correct.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, certainly wouldn't want to miss out on the ring bearer, who I believe, according to the schedule, is Danny Maloney and the lover girl, Lauren Maloney. Preparing for the toast, got to go to a little music to toast by. Everybody getting their glasses together. The servers are still pouring that last drop into the glasses.
You can't have
any. Yes, nothing like a little music to set the mood. Everybody with their glasses, I am going to hand the microphone over to a man who needs no introduction, so we're not going to give him one. Well, ladies and gentlemen, John's best man, Dan Tone. All right, thanks. Mike, remember to finish it for you. Grab onto your glass. As you sit here and you try to, or for the last several months, try to figure out something witty, yet poetic, to say that really can sum up all your feelings about this. When John asked me out in front of my house late last year to be his best man, and he was going to marry Susan, and he thought I would be very surprised, and he was probably shocked, but I wasn't very surprised. I know John really well. I'm not going to bore you all with the details of our 10, 11-year relationship, but we've gone from feeling great success and pride over some of the things that we've accomplished together to almost coming to blows in the parking lot of a marquee. And, you know, through it all, you get to just know someone, and I've never seen him happier than he is with Susan. He is so deeply in love with Susan, and I really think Susan feels the same towards him. They've had a great relationship together. They're really able to talk to each other and work through their problems, work through anything that might come up. And that open line of communication is really what's going to keep us alive for the rest of their lives. And I'd like everybody to grab their glass if they could. And I'd like to quote from their announcement, which says it better than anything I could come up with. May you have warm words on a cold evening, a full moon on a dark night, and the road downhill all the way to your door. Please join me in toasting their wonderful relationship.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Boy, that Dan's a man of few words, isn't he? Back in, we'll be opening for Frank Sinatra next month. Mike's now opening for Frank Sinatra next month, ladies and gentlemen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, right now, John and Susan, following this picture, would like to say some kind words to you. Everybody, ladies and gentlemen, the Brodersons.
This is the best day of my life, definitely. I wanted to thank everyone for coming and sharing this most perfect day with me and John, both of us, and everyone. Let's have some fun. Everybody, I love you.
And I love you. Okay, start the dancing and let's have a great time, okay? All right, ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for the entire head table here, huh?
Since a bright groom have to
Yo, very big smooch. Isn't that right, Brett? Regardless of whether they have food in their mouth, when their glass is fizzed all the
time. What now?
Wait.
Yeah, I don't even understand that.
No. Yes, sir.
Highly unlikely. This is
He wants a golf cart and a six pack of beer.
The butt, 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 the but
the American League. He's about a half step up.
Yes.